Hi, my name's Dawn. A whole bunch of you call me Spice Dawn. Some of you call me Felt Dipped Sample Dawn because I have this really neat playlist on my YouTube channel with all these interesting things about felt dipping samples. It makes them cheaper to mail to your customers and they're melt proof. I'll include the link to the original Spice Dawn's Felt Dipped Sample video so that you can get all the details on that because you're going to want to do it. And these are way cute, the way I'm going to do them right now, my little fall ones. This is called a triple dip, okay? I've only ever done a double dip, but now I'm doing a triple dip. And I have little fall leaves. And look at how cute they are. All right, now I'm going to show you how you do this, because there's a little trick to it. Got to pay attention. Three warmers lined up, okay? The shape that I've chosen, I'm going to fold up the little piece, okay, so it's not hanging down. See how I folded it up? Okay, now I am going to dip this in a pretty color. Okay, now I'm going to lay it there. Okay, get firm, please, get firm. Now, it's probably not firm, but we're going to do this anyway for the sake of not making you stand here while something gets firm. Fold up that piece again. Okay, now, dippy, 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 absorb. Okay, now I'm letting it have some hang time there.
That's beautiful.
It is pretty cool. Now, normally I would lay this on the parchment paper and I would let it get firm. But we know that you don't want to sit here forever. Not that it takes very long, but watch this. Okay. Ta-da! Now you have to pick scents, of course, that smell nice together. And I did. And then I'm going to lay that there.
After reviewing this video and showing another scentsy friend of mine the portion of the video that we'd already filmed, she had a lot of questions. So I says, you know what, I'm going to like make another piece and add it into the video. See, different shirt, different nails, different hair, so that we could answer some of those questions. Okay, now back to felt shapes. Okay, now no matter what you do, you'd better find a shape that will fit in the little zip bags that you are currently buying. Now this is a very special zip bag that I order very affordably. As you can see, it's a 2-inch by 3-inch, and the zipper runs across the 3-inch. So I'm not fighting stuffing these things down lengthwise. I can pop them in very easily. When you're making a lot of felt samples, you want to make it as easy to stuff as possible. Now, here's where I get my bags. I have been buying zip bags from these people for 21 years. Actually, my bookkeeper buys them. I have talked to them a few times and they're very nice. But when I explained what I wanted with the zip running the other way, you could even buy these so that they're not zipped when you get them. So you don't have to waste time unzipping them to fill them and then re-zip them. Like, how cool was that? That saves me a lot of time and a lot of sore fingers. So that is the bag, people. Okay? So there you go. Now, back to these shapes, okay? When I did it in the beginning of this video, I was just showing you real quick, but I realized that we needed to do more. So, I am going to show you more. If you can see my beautiful fall leaves, I always order the white felt. That way the strip shows, or I mean, the color of the wax shows true to color, okay? Now, I use 3 different colors. I didn't tell you what scents that I used because you can pick your own, but these are 3 that go very nicely together. Cider Mill, Honey Pear Cider is the yellow, and Christmas Cottage is the red. Okay, so now what I did first is I dipped all the red. Okay, so this shape I had to of course fold up the tip or it would get like the wrong color. So I dipped the red. Now I'm going to show you how I dipped the orange. Okay, now I'm going to flip this up too. I'm going to go this direction because I'm right-handed. Okay, now that gets that out of the way, so because you're going to do that in yellow.
Now, I dip it. Now watch. It's absorbing. It's absorbing. Now, I tap it. I find that on triple and double dipping, tapping is important. And then I let gravity help me. Gravity. It's soaking down, so it totally matches the red. Okay, now, I'm going to lay that down. Okay? Now, here is one that I've already dipped in the yellow. This one's probably ready to dip in the yellow, which is the honey pear cider. Now, check this out. Okay? Dippy, dippy. Absorby, absorby. Now, again, tap, tap. There's a white spot still, so I'm going to turn this, and I'm going to let gravity help feed the honey pear cider down into the white spot.
You're so now, good.
Listen, I have done thousands of these, and some of them aren't so cute. Like, sometimes you get, like, a big white spot in the middle, which actually kind of looks cool. But you're going to want to make a little, like, assembly line. Tap, tap, lay it down there. Another one. This is the second dipping. Tap, tap. Gravity, because it didn't absorb the whole way to the red, because you never know where the red's going to absorb to. They're all different. They are all unique.
It's pretty good you have the parchment paper all laid out for preparation.
Oh, I know, and my tweezers, because sometimes I don't let them dry enough. Okay, so now there. Now look, this one I'm picking up, and I'm going to dip again into... So you can do these pretty quickly. You have your 3 cents, your 3 colors. Like, you can, like, whip through it pretty quickly. But I wanted to point out, again, I always use white. Now, I bought some hearts. Aren't they cute? Okay, peony petals and lucky in love. So that'll be good for Valentine's Day. Of course, I'm not making these now. That would be way too far ahead of time. But I'm just showing you an example. Some of you, I saw on one of the groups that we're in, was doing a bridal shower. So you could do hearts for your bridal shower as their little favors. Now here, this doesn't look all that cool because it's still white felt dipped in. White, but I love white out. I love white out so much. It smells like candy canes. So I think that that's going to be terrific to have in someone's purse as a little sniff whiff. So that is what I am showing you here. So there's some more detail. You've got the bags. You know about the zip going this way. You know that it's, I always use personally, white felt. I just think it's better to show the true color of the wax. So now we're going to go on to more of the video, but I wanted to insert this so that you had some of the questions answered. And I have done thousands of these, thousands, but I put my little info on there for my customers, and it is quite nice. And I have a friend who makes the little shapes, and I am going to include her information in the description of the video, because she's really nice. She has a lot of neat shapes. So there you go. Now, if this video has helped you, and I know a lot of people have watched my felt dipped videos, well, you have to hit the thumbs up on YouTube, the like, okay? And heck, subscribe, because I like do a lot of videos. And people say, oh my goodness, what a good idea. So, like, you might want to be a subscriber. You can even use the little gear on the YouTube and set up notifications. So when I upload a new video, YouTube will tell you. So you can be like, on it, man, and watch that. Share it with your teams. It's like interesting stuff, I think. Wax and felt is a wonderful, wonderful pair. And it helps the consultant keep in touch with their customers without spending a lot of money on postage and without having the worry of a chunk of wax or a beautifully molded shape. Oh, molded shapes, they are so beautiful, unless it's a warm day and it melts in the truck on the way to the post office or on the way to the customer's house. Felt is self-absorbent and it will look just as pretty as it does now after spending a 95 degree day in a postal truck inside an envelope. So, there you have it. Bye.